Jay Haynes for the Film Sensei YouTube channel. Today in this video, we are going to work in Blender to create a text, which we will then convert to a fully actualized three-dimensional model, which we can bring into HitFilm. Okay, so we are in Blender. What I'm going to do is I'm going to highlight the default cube and hit my delete key to remove it. And then we're going to go ahead and we're going to add our text. So I'm going to click on Add Text. And you can see that there is a text laying flat here on the table. If I use my middle mouse button, I can scroll around and see it. What I want to do right away is go under the Transform tab here. Rotation of X, I'm going to make that 90 degrees so that it is now sitting upright. Okay. And I won't need that tab anymore. Instead, I'm going to click on this little icon that looks like an A, context object data. Clicking on that, you'll see I have several opportunities here to do things. The first thing I probably want to do is change the text to whatever I want it to be. So to do that, I'm going to click on this little drop-down box and say Edit Mode. Now, normally when you click on that, it will provide you with the vertices and the edges and the planes of the mesh that you're working with. But as you can see, this is not a mesh. A mesh normally has a little triangle here. This is a text, so it looks like a little half moon circle offset a little bit. So when you go into edit mode, you can actually edit the text. So I'm just going to hit my backspace, and I'm going to type in the word that I want to have. All right. Now that I've done that, I can go ahead and go back into object mode, and I can start messing around with it. Let's start with the paragraph settings here. Under alignment, I'm going to make this center. You don't have to if you don't want to. You can adjust the character spacing if you like. I'm going to leave that. If there was more than one word, you could adjust the word spacings. If there was more than one line, you could adjust the line spacings. This offsets X and Y, up and down kind of a thing. I am done with this, so I'm going to close that up. Let's go ahead and look at font. Right now it is what is called the Blender font, but if you click on this little open font folder looking icon, you can select any font you want. All you have to do is browse to wherever your fonts are and choose one, which I will do now. So I have selected the font that I want, and I can change the size of this to be any size that I want. I think I'll make it about 4. This shear means that it's just going to lean one way or another. If I choose to do that, I'm going to leave it at 0 so that it is basically straight up and down. Using my mouse or middle mouse button, I can see that it's still flat. So I'm going to open up the geometry folder, and under extrude, I am going to slide that out until I'm happy, maybe about 0.5. What do you think? Is that? That looks good to me. Okay. At this time, if I want to add a little bit of a beveled edge, I can do that. Here is the bevel right here. Depth, I would just maybe a few, let's go 0.05. That creates, that sort of swells the letters. So what I will do is offset that swell by negative 0.5 here to sort of bring it back down. So now we have this nice little beveled edge there. That's by choice. You don't have to do that, obviously. Okay. And then you can kind of play around and look at the rest of those things. But basically, in a nutshell, that's it. Okay. So now that I have created my text and I'm happy with how it is, I'm going to convert it to a mesh. Remember, it is still a text, and I need to convert it to a mesh or an object in Blender here. So the way I'm going to do that is under Object, I'm going to convert to a mesh from a curve, meta, surf, or text. And see that little triangle? When I click on that, now this is a little triangle, okay? Which means now it is actually a mesh, all right? And it is ready to be operated on as if it's a mesh. Basically, this is a three-dimensional object. At this point, I could say File, Export, as an FBX or as an object file or whatever, okay? If I want to shade this some sort of a color, I can do that. I would go to the shading tab and I would select new, which creates a new principled BSDF shader going into the material output. If I click on base color, I can change that color to whatever I want it to be. Okay. I think I will leave that as that because perhaps I might want to actually add some sort of a texture to it. So if I go to UV editing, clicking on that tab, here is my model. I will select or hit A to select everything. If I then under UV say Smart UV Project and click OK, now it has unwrapped that in the way that it feels that's best. Okay. So now if I go back to the shading tab, I can select something from a list. So I will bring in a picture. I have browsed here to a folder that has a bunch of pictures, and I will just grab one. I think I will grab this one, drag it into my workspace, and this color node I'm going to connect or whip to that right there. And now you can see that you have it shaded across the entire model or across the entire object. Okay. Now, if I wanted to, I could create a little bit of texture as well. Understand that right now I have basically standard issue specularity on it and roughness on it. I have a little bit of a sheen tint here. I could add a clear coat to it. I could add a metallic look to it, a shine. Okay, but if I wanted to actually add some texture, I certainly could do that. The way that I would do that would be through this displacement right here. Let me move this over a little bit. And I'm going to add, actually, I'm going to search for displace because I'm not sure where it is, displacement. Click on that, and I will drag it over here. And you can see, if I zoom in here a little bit, that this displacement is purple, and I'm going to plug it into purple. That doesn't do anything yet, but it will in a minute. Okay. What I want to do is I want to plug in this over into the height map of the displacement. But in Blender, you want yellow to connect to yellow and green to connect to green and blue to connect to blue. And generally, it's not a good idea to connect a yellow into a white. Although in this case, it probably would work. And then I would just adjust the scale. But there is a better way to do that. What you would want to do is add a converter, and the converter would be RGB to black and white. So now this basically is converting color into a black and white, and I would plug in the value of the black and white into the height. I'm going to go ahead and plug in the value of this, and I could use any picture. I don't have to use that particular one. And now if I just adjust the scale a little bit, okay, until I'm happy with what I want, maybe, yeah, that looks pretty okay, right? Okay, let's go with that, all right? So let's say now I am completely done and I want to go ahead and export that out. What I would do is say File, Export, and I can export as whatever. I think I will export it as an object file to my computer. And then when I have done that, I can go ahead and go into HitFilm from here. So now that I'm in HitFilm, I will select the little arrow next to import. And in the drop-down menu, I will select 3D model and search for it on my computer and bring it up. So now you can see in the viewer window that I have my 3D model, and it is exactly the way it came in from Blender. And if I choose, I can go ahead and make some modifications here. I might change the illumination model. I might change the reflection mode. I might, remove some of the shininess here and all that kind of stuff, or increase some of the roughness of it, that sort of a thing. However I feel like it, and when I am ready to bring it in, then I would select OK. Creating a new composite shot, clicking OK, I'll just drag this in. And from here, I can add a light to the scene, and I can just move that a little bit. Whoops, not the camera, but the light. Let me grab the light and slide it over, slide it up, slide it forward. And you can see basically that in pretty short order, I have been able to create a three-dimensional model of a word or of any text object and bring it into HitFilm ready to be used. So pretty much in a nutshell, that's it. If you have any questions, please leave them in the comments below. And if you like this kind of content, please do me a favor and like this video, subscribe to my channel, click the little notification bell for more, share this with your friends, and as always, thanks for watching.